I can't stop thinking on Edgewater, Captain. I'm glad the deserters are gonna be alright now they got power, but... what about the town? All those people.
You want to know what gets my bile churning? Edgewater has suffered a cavalcade of disasters, plague, marauders, desertion. Then you wandered in town. And I was so damn sure our luck was starting to turn. I never knew how right I was. Just answer one question for me. Why'd you do it? That power regulator is company property. Whatever you were hoping to find down here, I advise you to turn around and leave. I have got guards posted with orders to fire on you. Edgewater's dead. Our cannery's dead. Adelaide's deserters are never coming back. Spacer's Choice will shut us down before long. Some of us will die of illness by then. Some will move on. Some will starve. And as for me, I will tender my resignation, whereupon I shall be processed and then duly imprisoned for gross incompetence. Apologies won't give us our lives back, but for what it's worth, I am sorry too.
You picked a fine time to visit, stranger.
Maybe Adelaide was right to leave.
Desertion is a criminal offense, punishable by hard labor.
Heard you've been taking down marauders.
Are we getting paid or not?
Any loss of productivity will be deducted from your pay.
You're some sort of freelancer?
Got my hands full at the moment. Make it quick, please.
I don't know if the power is ever coming back. Life in that cannery.
Hey.
Cannery's dead. This is gonna throw a wrench into my actuarial tables. Power's gone. Law knows how long. Looking to get drunk?
Power's out, but I can't just leave my goods unattended. Don't suppose you'd care to do business? Go right ahead. Music to my ears.
I don't know what you did to talk some sense into Zoe, but I appreciate it. You hear that? That low, pleasant hum of electricity? It whispers across the veil like the winds of change. You've done well. I would have paid my last 5 bits to see the look on Reed's face when the last lamp in town burnt out and the cannery fell to silence. Time's come to look toward the future. We'll grow, I expect. A lot of workers out there with nowhere else to go. I don't look forward to turning folk away. Camp's gotta stay pure, though. Can't have corporate loyalists mixing with us, no matter how desperate they may be. I am curious. Why did you help us? You don't know who we are. You don't owe us a thing. The plant's crawling with mechanicals, so it stands to reason you risked your life. Well, I have got nothing against a little good old-fashioned pragmatism. You're welcome among us if you're ever so inclined.
Something I can help you with? Fresh off the limb, and that includes canid meat.
Is this your ship? Oh my star, she is just so handsome. Does she have a name yet? What's her drive model? Oh, gosh. Listen to me babbling. When I was in Edgewater, I dreamed of flying on a real ship, working on a real engine, belonging to a proper crew. Edgewater won't last another season without power, but that don't change the fact that I'm indentured to Spacer's Choice. Company expects me back at my post. I have imagined it, but until you came along, I never thought I had the choice. I want to ask you something, and you can say no. But can I come with you? I could tend to your engine. I know my G-valves from my catalyzers, and I can keep your ship singing. And if you ever need a pair of eyes watching your back, I can do that too. What do you think? I mean, thanks. You won't regret this, mister. Captain. I can call you Captain now. Ha! I got a captain. Something you need?
Well, I certainly am looking forward to flying on a ship named the Unreliable. I'll just head upstairs and claim a room. As always, I am at your disposal. Anything you'd like to discuss? Nothing too out of the ordinary. Just your run-of-the-mill vicar with a violently enthusiastic disposition. That's what my parents called it. I grew up in a pit of a town, much like Edgewater. I was destined to be a laborer like my parents, but I was infected early with a need to solve the equation. My passion didn't sit well with them. My parents, ironically. They internalized the precepts of scientism like no one I've ever known. They had a pure faith, a faith that brought joy to them regardless of the situation. I envied that. I wanted that peace. I thought if I became a vicar, I could find it. Or at the very least, find out why I lacked it. They thought I was fighting the plan, should have accepted my lot. Some people pursue the clergy for power, prestige, but that was not me. The plan is not one rigid path. There are a variety of multitudes contained within it. Our paths have variants, but we'll end up adhering to it, whether we like it or not. Some choices make the path smoother, some rougher. You can even go outside the lines, but the further outside you go, it's like an unbreakable elastic band. It will only stretch so far before it snaps back. The further it is stretched, the more violent the eventual correction. I have run headlong into too many walls in my pursuit of the truth. This book is my last hope, and you were my only hope of getting it translated. I honestly don't know what I'd do. This quest has consumed me for the better part of my life. I fear there's nothing else left to me. What about you? What's your story? And how did he do that? Well, you do seem different than every other colonist. Let's pretend for the moment I believe you. What are you going to do now? That seems a dangerous proposition. Why risk your life now that it's been returned to you? Oh, I see. You have my condolences. I've been thinking on that. There's a former infamous philosopher scholar who fled Terra 2 some years ago. He's an expert on Bakonu. He's also who told me of the Journal's presence in Emerald Vale. If anyone in this colony could translate that book, it would be him. That's a good question. We should start on the Groundbreaker. It's where I'd go if I wanted to get off Terra 2. Great place to pick up a ride to Hephaestus, Scylla, even Monarch. All I need is access to a data cartridge from the security terminal. Their easily hackable system keeps a registry of all crew manifests for both arrivals and departures. Before I transferred to Edgewater, I had a wealth of time to develop certain, secular skills during my years serving a particular penitentiary flock. I meditated, led sermons, provided guidance to the inmates as needed, of course. I also played prison yard tossball and taught myself a bit about computronic security systems. I'll comb the last 6 months of departure manifest to track the Philosophist's off-world destination. Thank you, Captain. Yes, you caught me ruminating again. Guilty as charged. What's occupying your thoughts? Of course. Are you ready to break into security on the Groundbreaker?
Where are we headed?
Captain, I have detected that the town of Edgewater is now without power. I appreciate you doing your part to hasten their demise. What can I do for you, Captain? All systems are operating within acceptable parameters. I am prepared to bring the Unreliable into low-altitude orbit. This should prove an adequate test of our flight capabilities.